It is going to be Train, not Inferno. It is going to be Helium and Launders. Let's see how it pans out. Take it away, boys.
All right, thank you, guys. Professional to the end down there on the desk, but we get over to Train now. Map 3, Vex Gaming on the CT side. CLG starting out on the T side, the harder one here on Train. What do you make of it, Launders?
It's tough to say. I mean, CLG, I just feel like aren't hitting shots right now, and that's been their biggest issue. And apart from them just having good setups, like, this game has so much to do with aim. And if you aren't on point, it's just going to cost you so much. Now, we did see them come back on Dust 2, but that map was a lot closer than maybe it should have been in the first place. So with those things in mind, maybe their chances are low. But here is Fugly to do a little bit of damage to Furland. He's in a headshot position. I mean, he could get another kill from here. And looks like Fugly gets gushed. I don't know
Help's
if that was
coming.
By his teammate, but
help is coming real fast. Oskarsh is actually just going to move up. Groovy's there as well. They're all moving out. Tarik from super far away takes down Furland, but again, he was low. CLG left in a good spot right now. 4-on-4, and Oskarsh is very low on HP, and they're going to swarm into the inner site, get that bomb down.
Yep. Now they just have to play after plant, but the thing is they can't just play static. They actually have to get a kill on players pushing up, otherwise they won't be able to defend. It's super easy to retake inner, and there aren't a lot of great spots, and that's the reason. Here's JDM to look for damage.
And it goes the other way. As they're trying to get to spots, they get picked off. Rollin brought down one of them. Now JDM playing on the other side of this train at lower. Rollin finds him as well. Two kills on the retake, and Repo's on the bomb. Gets the defuse. Here comes Tarik flying, trying to even look like get a knife in the smoke. Can't do it. Cutler remains alive, and with the kill, he even had that Molotov ready to bounce off the door, but they smoked on the bomb anyway, so that was rendered useless. And Vex Gaming start off with momentum here, and that could spell trouble for CLG given the way that Cobble went.
Yeah, that was a really nice decision, I think, to use the smoke on that plant and get on it as soon as they knew the kit was in position to start defusing. And, you know, we saw the face of Haze there. Extreme disappointment since they had two alive and no one to actually stop the bomb from being defused. Or even three, actually. And yeah, Vex again coming in with another pistol. That's going to be a huge factor in their series if they end up winning, counting the amount of pistols and rounds that they have won because of it.
Well, up pushed in the trains, that's going to be Furlan and Oscar. Groovy on the A bomb site, on the bomb train itself. Rollin spotting from lower over there in inner, and Repo on the back of the upper catwalk. So playing pretty reserved and far away from any upgraded pistols that might just be able to peek out and get a one-tap. CLG is still spread out. Fugly working over at Ivy, and actually backup is coming in the form of a Cutler and JDM bomb also going that way. It'll be a delayed outer split with the, if you put Ivy first, a 3-1-1.
So tough to come away with rounds on T side. They don't come easy. I think Furlan actually spotted someone peeking him, and yeah, he did, but doesn't take much damage for that, though a double smoke does come out at Ivy. The thing is they're going to push through it looks like, and will they face the bombas of Furlan? They will, but they will go down as well. And JDM and Fugly getting two kills apiece means it's going to be 3v3. Rallin wrapping the site, gets a kill on Haze. And as I say that, two more players go down. Vex coming away with that round, keeping three alive in that 3v3 situation. 2-0 now, CounterLogic Gaming, because they got that plan on the first round, are going to be able to buy. So that is one thing that they can be happy about.
Yeah, and it looks really good initially for CLG. They're able to make progress down Ivy, coming through the alley. The FAMAS has not landed its shots. It actually goes down. CLG have a man advantage for a second, but when the inner rotators come back over, they clean up the mess very, very quickly. Almost all three of those kills at the exact same time. And now the op out onto Rollin. Into the first rifle, though, of course, because CLG did plant in the pistol, so that gets them started a little bit earlier on their T side.
Yeah, also, yeah, just seeing Repo again playing inner just gives me a lot of faith that Vex have a stake in this game, because he played this position so well yesterday. And, you know, if Vex are just more on fire, I think that is going to be a huge factor in whether or not they can win. Oskarsh is playing Ivy with a P90 spotting, and it seems like playing close, because that's the only way he's going to be able to get a kill. So, I mean, technically this makes this spot a little bit weaker, or that much weaker, because of it.
Well, Groovy pushed up against that red train there, looking at a pretty unique angle past E-Box and into ladder room. It'll be kind of tough to find a fallback position, so he's going to need to be very, very quick with the reactions, and the aim will have to be on point, and they're actually going to test this. Haze running over now, Groovy. That's what I'm talking about, not able to fall back. The flash was there for a teammate, but it was a little too late. Haze gets the headshot before being blind. Now things may be falling apart, but Rollin hits the op shot. Oscar gets one with a P90. 3-on-3 right now. Couple players low. Fugly able to get one more, but then traded. Repo, one versus two. That's your man. That's on inner, making his rotation into the Z connector. Is going to spot Fugly, who hopped up onto the train. Fugly might have likewise seen him. Repo will push the smoke. Spots a man on red. That's Tarek. He gets the kill, and CLG are on the board.
Yeah, and that's Repo's. That's going to be Repo's job if they can't hold outer, is to either rotate through Z or ladder if he pushes early enough. And CLG coming with a round nice and early, too. I mean, that's really good for them. Vexed, because of it, have to save now. And look like they're actually spending quite a bit of money, anticipating a double save, most likely. Armor pistol here for Vexed. If they're able to win this one, it's going to be a not like this moment for for CLG, excuse me.
To those moments might be a little more down the road, Launders. JDM going to get the op shot onto Rollin. Nicely done as he tries to push up and get aggressive. And this is pistol armor too, right? Vex put a lot of money into this. They're forcing up, still trying to play for the high risk, high reward. And it looks like it might just be high risk because Tarek brings down Groovy now 5-on-3.
I immediately don't like this decision to buy now that, I mean, not because they actually bought, but because they didn't seem to have a plan going into the round. They just played one up close T connector, one pushing in the ladder by himself, you know, getting shot in the side. And if you're going to buy it just because you're anticipating a double save, okay. But if you don't have a plan for it, then is it really worth it? I'm not sure. And, you know, not even doing economic damage here. So they can try to, what their best bet here is to try to get the exit frags and by cutting off the rotations, not actually trying to retake the site and see what kills they can get, but figure out where it is that CLG want to exit, and CLG want to exit together and basically just avoid Vex at all costs. So as soon as someone has a lead, they might just follow.
Yeah, well, they've got T-Con control, and they're exiting there, so I assume everyone goes that way, like you mentioned. Exactly what's happening. Man down there is Oscarish at Ivy, and at that range with the 5-7. I'm not actually sure you can hit people with a 5-7 from that far away. So everyone for CLG is going to be safe, and three armors are saved for Vex Gaming. No one going to go on the hunt for CLG.
Yep. You know, they can recycle the armor, which is one thing to note for Vex, which is nice for them. But CLG have it now 2-2, and most likely the ability to win this round as well, but not only that, have earned themselves a nice comfortable buffer on their economy because they were able to keep five alive last round. Cutler hanging on to a UMP, and I'd like to see them just use him to scout a site by himself.
Same. That'll eat through that armor that is still up on Oscar's Repo and Ferlin as well. Really getting pretty aggressive on the blue train. Might actually be able to find something here. He is going down the ladder. JDM doesn't have the angle. Now he sees it. Gets dinked down to 5 HP. Just a little too far away from that 5-7 or P250, whichever it was. I think it was too far away.
Well, for some teams, that might scare them into a full push inner, but and that's what Vex want, but it doesn't look like that will be the case. Vex taking the risk of putting four people inside, which is what you want to do, you know, ultimately. Pick a site and hold it or do some aggressive push, but play together because sometimes two pistols is better than rifle, but one-to-one will almost always lose. And Fugly on the hunt, it looks like, oh, doesn't get the kill and was actually stranded a little bit. I mean, gives up an AK here. This gives reason suddenly to CLG to chase when they didn't have one originally.
Yeah, what can Vex do? Can they make it expensive? Maybe, well, best case is come away with some weapons taken from the other team, and they've done that at least once. Rollin has got a kill and got himself an AK for it, so that's going to be a massive save, and why not? You still got a lot of value with the armor kit nades and even the 5.7s that are out there. 7,200 equipment value that Vex can save in this round going into the next. That's, well, that much money they won't have to spend. That could go a long way as they try to get back on their feet after a force buy with no plan a couple rounds ago, fell completely flat on its face, put them on hard time. CLG able to get that lead back, and something they could not do on Cobble was win rounds in a row. Yep. Here they've got three in a row.
They've got three in a row. They also have, like, just, I mean, they've got not an equipment value lead, but in terms of how much money they have in the bank, just so much more than Vex. I mean, Vex are in a situation where if they lose this round, they're back to saving, and then suddenly Cloud9 have almost all the rounds they already, or CLG, I keep saying Cloud9. CLG have almost
soon
all the rounds
Wonders.
They soon, yeah. All the rounds they need to win the whole map, really. Though I actually think that you know what? Vex played particularly badly on their, or poorly on their CT side, and, that flash was a double-edged sword there, actually. Oh, blinded JDM, and so it works out in his favor, but blinded Rowland as well, who comes in for the re-peek and is there first.
double-edged sword, but it still strikes in the favor of Vex Gaming here as Rollin gets the pick onto JDM. Sniper duel one. Tarek, we did see him double-opping a little bit on Cobble as an adjustment. Didn't work, but that's why he's going to pick up the op here as the secondary on the T side for CLG. He's still going to want to try to use that to find the opening pick. A minute left on the clock, and Vaxxed are very congregated up back of that bomb train and by green train. Just heavy presence towards that back hall on Ivy.
Tarek will be hard-pressed to find a peek wide enough for him to get a kill from that side of Ivy, and has been slowly aggressing while Cutler has been keeping them honest inside, and it looks like with the presence over at Ivy, you wouldn't expect to see a rotate this heavy towards inner, but because the bomb is here, it seems like they're going to want to take this part of the map versus one player. Grubby is going to be his support to come and spot upper, but he doesn't have an op, so this gives him a good opportunity to take inner. That is CLG.
Yeah, well, Repo was making some pretty big plays in this inner site. There he goes with the first kill, bringing the bomb down, and this can be a problem when you are a man down on the T side as the shots continue to land. They connect for Vex Gaming is you're very often like, all right, we want to just stay in our post plants. Two people on the upper catwalk, two at ramp, send one man in and just get him to plant the bomb. They send the bomb in kind of alone without support. I guess it looks like kind of close behind. There was one more going in. And everything falls apart as soon as Repo hits that first headshot.
Yeah, that is sometimes the key frag. And, you know, Groovy coming in was super good. I mean, his aim looks super good, getting two nice, clean M4 silence headshots on players crossing. And the way CLG took inner, it was very loose because they spent a lot of their utility at Ivy. And what they needed to do, basically, is get down the ramp and get the first kill right away so that they don't need so many smokes to cover their plant. They're basically hoping that the site was being played thin enough that they could only have one man to face, but ultimately Vexed were shooting a little bit too well there.
JDM still expecting someone over on red. Actually, did they go up on top of the bomb train? I think they did. Maybe even boosted on top of it. I'm not sure if it kicks you off or not, if there's a skybox there, but either way, JDM spots one jumping.
Yeah, that's a really interesting way to peek that T-Con. So many people go up on the
red train, which is what JDM was watching.
Yeah, but from T-Con, the little wood pile.
Oh, yeah.
Or crater, what have you.
Pallet.
Pallet, there it is. The wordsmith himself. Coming in hot. And Fugly, jump crossing Ivy, okay. Just to bait out a peek or try to get someone to shoot.
Now they will be smoked. Time is starting to get low, and wow, what a big nade actually. 60 damage in total, bringing both of them to 70. The smoke goes down, it's kind of by that box, and they might expect the boost to come over this. Let's see if Fernland puts a crosshair up there. Nope. Still just playing within that smoke. Cutler looking to set up a pop flash into ladder room, try to take the control there. CLG, they want to split outside right now, and with the time that they have left, because of the bomb's position, not being in ladder, but at T-Con, pretty much have to go outside. And Ferlin making the first contact and staying alive. He's going to buy so much time. Incendiary down. Now JDM can't help at all. He'll kill himself, but it doesn't matter. Well, maybe it will. 15 seconds. Oscarish at the back train stop there. Brings down Cutler. JDM finds Rollin, and bomb going to go down. 8 seconds on the clock. That's more than enough. Now it's going to be over. All they have to do. Oscarish has just got to run away, but he's being chased down. JDM gets the frag with the P250.
Oh.
And there you go, man.
I won't repeat it if you want.
I won't.
I will if you will. All right.
I won't.
Play chicken with you there, mate. getting that kill in the last seconds of the round at that P250, not very much HP either. JDM did a good job of staying alive at Ivy, getting someone to kill themselves so that they could make a pathway for him.
Incendiary didn't go quite far enough.
And that's another round for CLG. Vex, fortunately for them, have still enough money to gather like some type of buy. Rallin, though, who would have enough, now has a deagle, and they are going up against a rush inner while four people were originally outer, and Repo goes down as a solo man inside, and it looks like a very good round so far for CLG.
Groovy able to get one as they try to push forward. Was that hazed off of the ladder?
That was, yeah, Fugly on the ladder, I think, got that headshot.
Or it's Fugly, okay, yes, hazed is elsewhere. Oscarish gets one more, so still making it a bit costly. JDM can find this last kill, send off another round with the team ace, and I believe that's... Oh, no, that was Tarek. That's still out at ladder. He was going to be that lurk, and if they needed it, could have wrapped around it and come through the Z connector, but it wasn't needed. And now they're just going to fan out, try to find Oscarish.
Yeah, they would really like to find him. He did, I think, throw Tarek through a bit of a loop there, crossing back to the train that he originally spotted Tarek at, and now is in CT making a little bit of noise, and we'll take a bullet to the side of the face. Won't look him in the eyes. in that exchange. And now Counter Logic Gaming have 5 rounds. That's huge for them. They've got tons of money. Decks are certainly, almost certainly going to save. And again, we'll start to run away with this half, but again, I fear for CLG on their CT side. It seems like that's been the biggest issue for them. Their Dust2 started to clean up towards the end, but they did, you know, sacrifice quite a few rounds. And went rounds that came close that could have gone either way. And then on Cobble, just had almost no CT side to speak of.
Yeah, and it is looking good for CLG right now, starting to put up rounds on the T side, but that may not be a problem for Vexed either going into the second half. In their match against SK, it was a 12-3 half from the T side, remember, and it took them a while to close it out on the CT side, so it's a bit shaky. And that could just be the reason, lacking your in-game leader, kind of having to pug through your CT side, could be tough, whereas if you just go very, very quick on the T side, maybe you don't need the strats as much if you can just hit the shots and run over people. Which kind of seems backwards from what people normally say. Without an IGL, you're going to struggle on T side, but yeah. Food for thought.
Certainly, both sides require a different type of coordination, and we've seen teams be CG sided as well as T sided and struggle, no matter what the map favors. But here are some kills happening on this retake. Actually, something to note, now it's a 2v3 man advantage to Vexed as Rowlin is pushing up the side of middle, and tries to get a kill on Fugly, but can't do it. Now it's Furlan with the op. Will he try to save here? Hits Fugly in the leg through the bottom of the train, but Haze trades him out, and they do come close to winning, but can't actually close it. And here is a timeout. Have we seen any maps that haven't had any timeouts? I think we have, right?
Well, we didn't see both of them on Cobble.
Yeah, no, I mean...
Actually, did we even see a timeout on Cobble? Because I got a pause for free just based on a technical problem.
Mm-hmm. I think so. But I was saying outside of the series, it seems like there's been... a pause, basically five or, you know, well, now 9 runs into this half on each side of most maps.
I mean, it seems foolish not to take it, right?
You're
given this opportunity to take these pauses. Now the stakes are super high, especially considering you could end up going home in 2 best of ones.
Yep.
Both of these teams played well enough to earn a best of 3, of course. Well, actually, CLG went straight to the lower bracket, right?
I think they did. They lost versus Splice, and then
we're able to win one more down there in the lower bracket best of one elimination match. So they faced a bit more pressure than Vexed, whereas Vexed did at least win their first best of one. So went into another one with a little less pressure, but weren't able to prevail. That's why Splice moved forward. Splice, excuse me, I know I kind of append a D onto it. The organization called me out on it the other day. Sorry, I'm just not good at speaking.
Now you have to get a Splice tattoo.
No. That's who was on that deal? Oh, that was
yeah, that's not your color.
Yanko and Sadakis.
Sadakis, yeah.
If they get out of the group stages at the major, which is, you know, it's a pretty safe bet from them.
Hey, I'll tell you what. If Splice get out of groups at the major, I will tattoo Splice logo on Sadakis.
You'll do the tattoo.
Yep.
I don't know. We saw was it Knocker draw Splice's what their new logo should be with the snake screaming woo.
Yeah.
That was golden. Tattoo that.
Personification of Hazed, of course. Or not Hazed, sorry. Abe.
Abe, yeah, exactly. A tattoo right on the foreheads. I think Richard Lewis suggested that one. That would be perfect. And let's see, 1 minute in the pause. And Vex, they need to get something done. And I'll be honest, Train, I think the CT side, even though it is still a very CT-sided map, if it's one you practice and play a lot, the communication in the outer bomb site is absolutely vital, and maybe missing an in-game leader and a strong voice and a strong player in the form of Hyper could actually be affecting their CT sides. But we did see that the Terra side was extremely explosive.
Yeah, I think it's just something to do with the natural chemistry of Polish teams. It just, you know, it's intangible, but it happens so often where they just do so well on Train, especially on the T side, where if they get rolling, they just can't be stopped. And I don't know. It might be the way they communicate. It might be a cultural thing. But
like a runaway train, perhaps, that can't be stopped.
I'm leaving.
Hey. Oh, the headphones have been put down. Uh-oh. CLG leading 6-3. And Vex feeling energized. Will everyone witness the power of the pause? Repo going to get a little bit aggressive there at the lower ramp, but back off. And a heavy stack to the outside. 3 in the back of that A bomb site. Oscar pushed up into ladder, and Repo playing on the back of that inner Pop Dog train.
Yep. Now, he can only have so much info, but as long as he stays alive, has basically done his job. Even a 5v5 retake is actually doable. I mean, there just aren't 5 spots on this side of the map to justify having someone die if it's possible for them to live. For the T's coming down the ramp, I mean, you've got, you know, Pop Dog Train, and then you've got Bomb Train, which is like one or two spots, and then Upper, which can get smoked out, and so not all that useful. JDM getting aggressive Upper, taking a peek, and will he find a kill? Oh, what a
wow.
Shot onto Groovy.
That one's beautiful.
Ooh, finishes off with a nice B-hop. Very clean.
Stuff that gets Launders really excited.
It's the priorities.
So JDM getting the opening pick there, and it was quite a shot to do so. Groovy's down. Rollin with his op, has he moved at all? He's actually way back in the inner bomb site right now. Furlan looking to make a play. Vex Gaming, very often if they go down a man early, they will look to make a play, and CLG knows this. I was talking with Ryu a little bit, the coach of Selfless. And all right, hold that thought for a second as it turns into a 4-on-2. Rollin back of the old bomb train here with that op. And he'll be running away to save and repo up in the hall. So I'm going to go back to that point. I was talking with Ryu. He was sitting down. Actually, Selfless was the last team to beat CLG on train. So I went to him like, hey, what's going on with their train? And he told me that obviously NA helping NA here, scratching each other's backs. They all sat down and watched train demos of Vex Gaming among some other maps. And they realized that if they get that first kill, the entry kill from their T side, Vex Gaming are going to really, really want to try to make a play. So they know absolutely if they get a kill, the tendency from Vex is push, and they baited out perfectly there at Ivy in this round.
Yeah, I mean, it's just a matter of what they'll push, because it's almost your duty once you go down a man to try to get that info back in some way, even up for free. And, you know, if they can telegraph exactly what part of the map is going to be aggressed, then they can take advantage of that and continue to dominate the round. And for CLG, the half, I mean, they've are touching on 16k right now. JDM's going to start having to buy for other people at this point. Whereas Vexed are, just hurting for anything they can get. Furlan only has a UMP, and he's going to be playing somewhere outside. I don't even think he's probably going to be pushed up Ivy with this weapon, if not ladder.
Yeah, no attention given to Ivy from CLG on this round. They're all going to run up into the halls, and it looks like it could be a quick play just into the inner bomb site. And what does Repo have? He's there alone. He's got no utility whatsoever. Rallin has rotated over. He brings the op and utility, but going to be initially more focused on opping. That's for sure. Cutler looking to peek off the upper catwalk.
Yep.
Oh, yeah, smart decision. You've got the utility. You can kind of expect that they don't.
So grouped up on the ramp right this, trying to push Repo out of his comfort zone and actually have him going back to the site. And here we have that retake situation where no, CLG know that they have to get a kill. Hayes pushing through the smoke and getting punished for it, while Fugly runs up Pencil and finds a frag, and now he has the opportunity to get more information or even push into CT, which would be so smart of him. Someone looking to trade. No, Fugly finds two kills in this round, but it is 2v3. The flank comes out.
Oh,
Furlan
no.
With the UMP gets both kills on the retake, and that ends the round for CLG. Well played by Vexed. Good patience and good trust in their teammates.
There was actually a Rallin kind of making the difference. He gets smoked off, but then he goes up on the catwalk still at an angle where they can't really see him from that far away, trying to bring down the planter as they retreat out of the bomb site. And I think he does end up with two kills, and there was some timing there. I think, was it Hayes that was pushing down Fuel Tanker? Like, if he had got underneath, kills Rallin for free, the round's probably over, but then he's caught off guard.
Yeah, I think also, I don't know if they had anyone dedicated to watching the ladder flank, but that would have been a kill that saved them and helped them regain man advantage. Also, they could have used the ladder position to flank Z, which is something that we used to see Swag doing all the time. It happened, I think, on pistols, where he would hold ladder, or you'd have that guy holding ladder. Obviously not the only man to do it, but once you held ladder for long enough, know that you could use that info, if no one's going on big flank, to actually use that as a big flank yourself. Because again, Inner just doesn't have that many good spots. So we saw that bomb go down 5v5, and yet CLG got eviscerated. But one for one in this round.
All right, well, JDM spotted the other opper. That was Rollin. He throws a flash and try to take back over the angle, and he actually switches it too. Goes on to the train by Z to spot it, and now just into the Z connector as Furlan hanging out on the back of that blue train here in Sandwich. It might be Tarek in charge of opening up the map from this position. The Bomb and JDM are waiting at ladder, and they're going to go for the split. One at Ivy will be Fugly. He's actually getting out for free here, but it may not matter because Furlan and Rallin are just bringing everybody down. And Ferlin with another. He's going to get Fugly. That was the player coming from Ivy, so no problem. And JDM was trying to go in late, be that sniper support, but everything fell apart before he could go help.
That round makes me wonder how much they were relying on Haze to try to get an entry on outside before they're able to take it. I mean, that was 4v4, and we see five players from Vexed alive. It didn't seem like they had anyone to cause them any problems. And that's partially because, one, they didn't use the smoke execute. They tried to just split outside organically. And because of that, they did put a lot of pressure on whoever was going out first to open it up so that whoever came out T-Con second or Ivy had a little bit more information. But as they couldn't do that, that made their take look very lackluster. That's, I think, a failure to keep up the explosiveness. Groovy having the feeling that, oh, JDM is going to be right there, but here he is. Hearing him come up the ladder, scoped on him.
So a lot of rounds put in a row for ZLG. They had seven within an eight-round span. So they had a lot of money. You had even commented on at one point JDM was floating near $16,000, so just having to drop for his teammate. So able to lose two in a row and still come out to a very powerful full-strength rifle round, even the op onto JDM, but this is the last time they're going to be able to manage that one. JDM still has 4.2K. But as a team, they will not be able to buy. So Vex Gaming can earn themselves a free one off of this and actually tie it up. So round 13, a lot of importance here.
Yeah, you know, Vex still going to be on their feet here. I think this is a round that they would bite on a fake really well. It came to the point. Oh, and we'll hold that as Oscar actually gets two kills through the smoke.
Still alive, still buying time. Spotted again at an electrical box, unable to fall back to the back of red. Now smoke will go down. He's blind himself, trying to go for another one. Full blind and through the smoke. Why not? Hazed. Going to bring it back, potentially gets a shot onto Ferlin, and Oscar is still so dangerous. Here's that footstep, and he's able to get Fugly before he can get to old hell. Haze gets the trade out, two kills for him, but he's on 4 HP. JDM now, it's time for him to go to work with the op. He's not really been that present as a strong opping star for the team here in this tournament, and on this round, can't find anything either.
Yeah, well, on this map, the kill distribution is very very narrow for CLG and for Vex, very top heavy. But even on that round, we have like someone coming out of the woodwork, and that's Oscarish. Previous rounds, we've had Grubby show up, and Rowlin overall doing extraordinarily well. Now Haze is going to try to hang on to this op. That's going to be a hard save. Oh, sorry, that's Rowlin and Ladder. Excuse me. Haze has an op for himself, 4 HP at Ivy. And time to work with, but outside, you're more than likely going to find two people, and I feel like he's going to be cognizant of this, but does get the kill, has an opportunity to plant. All the back lanes are clear, whether or not he knows it.
Oh.
And Rowlin does find him, picking up that frag. Would have been a hard round to win in spite of that. But they get the bomb down, and, you know, as much as we were talking about CLG's economy, they suddenly don't have that much money left over. And, you know, 16K can quickly be depleted when you're spending more than you would even need to most of the time. Like, you know, between 5 and 6K plus your opper, spending even more than that.
Yeah, and you mentioned the top-heavy frag distribution over on Vexed, and that's just because Rowlin, it is CT-sided with that op. Granted, they haven't been off to a great start and don't even ultimately have that many rounds or as many as you would expect on a CT map, but he's been doing a great job getting the op frags, sometimes finding the first kill of the round, able to beat out JDM occasionally, but making that rotation from inner to outer and being where the action is very, very well.
Oscarish gets a really nice flash, doesn't know how impactful that flash really was, but three players crossing Ivy, which we've seen CLG do on their eco before, where they try to run up through this smoke, and it looks like Oscarish is going to have a field day here. Can fully expect to see one more person coming through. We'll eat a flash, but does still get away with his life.
All right, there we go. There is justice in the world. Cutler rewarded for using a flash and pushing a smoke. And well, 7 HP, a nade, a tech 9, and a big dream right now. Maybe he can stay alive and they can talk about what they're going to do in that next round when they get their money back.
Yeah. Ooh, Ferlin actually. Oh, whoa. Ferlin doing a lot of, taking a lot of damage for that. And two players are knocked down, but we're going to the last round, last round of the half, so it doesn't even matter. Vexed are going to have the buy that they want. CLG are going to have the buy that they want. And now both teams are fighting for the eighth round to see who is going to be really, really dominant this half. And actually, even if Vex win this, they aren't going to be able to hold that title. So we'll just have to make do with whatever they have left over and hope for a pistol, certainly.
Well, who will win the half? Going to come down to the very last round to find out who will get eight. That's Repo and Ferlin actually playing inside, and a quick rotation in from that Z connector. That's going to be by Rollin. And we've got JDM, Hayes, Cutler, and Fugly all grouped up in the halls. I think JDM is responsible for watching that ladder, which is surprising considering he's the one with the op.
I think this is a nice read from Vex. I mean,
Terex got outside.
Yeah. Smoke goes down. Pop Dog. Rallin with the op inner, supporting two people. Groovy gets his kill outside, and that's going to push the aggression inner to try to even up.
That hurts. Tarek got out to E-Box. I thought that was going to be a pivotal position in the round, but he goes down, and of course he's operating alone. Groovy kills him, barely even took any damage, so just right away it's Vex with the 5-on-4 as they try to win out on the half. Hayes able to get one entry onto the inner site, but Ferlin then trading him out. Cutler on the back in the battle, but ends up shooting into the train. Fugly and JDM now coming alive. Shot onto Ferlin, gives them the man advantage. Ruby on the back of that bomb train, red train, sees Fugly by fuel tanker and able to get his second kill of the round. And the post plant position already is JDM. Fugly gonna be hard to get off. Okay, just kidding, jumping out of cover there. Wasn't exactly sure where Oscarich was going, who's now left in a 1v2. Pushing up to Pomp Dog, taking a quick look at lower, jumping all over the place. Gonna move in now, he has to. Oh, nearly getting the kill there on the color. That would have made things very, very interesting. You did see the Molotov was ready to be thrown off the upper door, though. And CLG find the half victory 8-7.
Oh, I think, yeah, they find the half 8-7. That was, you know, they went inner, and it looked like to their own demise, as they had two riflers stage playing close-up inner, and then a opper back at Z to support them. So it was a full-on stack from Vex. They fully expected an inner take. They even got the lurk kill on Tarek outside. You know, shut that down, shut that aggression down completely. Removed all information from CLG on the other side of the map. And even though they fell right into their lap inner, they still managed to hold, or they still managed to break through and get all the frags that they needed. And we look back at a round where they, you know, Repo was playing inner solo. They played 5v5. They let the bomb go down, and yet they still won. So, you know, that's how easy it can be. And we see how easy it can be sometimes to just retake inner and just try to keep people alive.
Yeah, and then again, back to my conversation that I had. Now that we go into the half where it's a bit more relevant based on what Ryu told me, it'll be CLG on the CT side. He said they are very, very susceptible to fast coordinated outer takes. It's going to be difficult for CLG to hold those. They know that about themselves.
They know that about themselves?
Yeah.
Oh, that's a huge problem because Vex are extremely good at fast coordinated outer takes. Like, their coordination on T side is nothing to overlook. We saw them just run over SK, who, again, was another team that we thought were a favorite over them. And so this might be a very explosive half.
Yeah, if Vex Gaming get the pistol, the first rifle, Ryu said something like a 5-0, which obviously meant the CLG is having started on the CT side. So if Vex Gaming have a fantastic start to this T side, it might be. I mean, it's a polished squad. It could be, you know, the smaller brother to the Virtus Plow, the Vexed Plow.
Yeah, the Vexed Plow.
Could come alive here.
For sure. That's crazy. It's coming down to this third map. You know, it seems like a great half for CLG, but if they're, you know, they have a weakness where Vex have a strength, that's going to be their kryptonite. Now, I think, you know, to counteract that, like, typically you play one pushed up E-Box or someone on T-Con to try to get the kills early versus the Execute so you can shut it down early. But I think what they just need to focus on is making the smokes dissipate if there is going to be some kind of... Actually, you know, we won't even see that many. Like, we won't see, like, a 5-smoke outer take from Vex, I don't think.
Probably
they
not.
Just like to run out, get health control, get sandwich control, and...
A couple smokes on the run, a couple Molotovs as well to the back halls.
Abuse
push the players back and take control of that space and get the bomb down.
Abuse the confusion. So maybe if... CLG just kind of desert a lot of the frontal areas of outer where a lot of the flashes will come over, Molotovs and stuff like that, and just try to work on a flank, like focus on Ivy control, maybe try to get around through T-Con or even push inner once in a while if they think it's going to be something fast outside. Vex they sell fakes, actually. I don't want to discredit them in that regard, but I haven't seen them on train, so maybe there is some hope for CLG if they're able to make the proper adjustments and with the extra pair of eyes that is PETA. It can give them an outside perspective on what they were missing in the past on their train.
Yeah, that's true. They're playing again with all five of their teammates, plus their one coach who is, you know, a former player himself.
Yeah.
So they've got a lot of depth in that and strategies, experience to rely on. And then you got it on the other hand, you've got Vex, who are going to just absolutely need to start quick. Otherwise, they might run into trouble because they're without Hyper, one of their star players, and their in-game leader, and don't have a coach. They have a teddy bear.
That's true. Power of the teddy? Who knows?
Perhaps.
No, they move out into this pistol. Furlan has got a few. It seems like a smoke for lower ramp. That's what it looks like to me. But I'm not sure how they'll use it.
Going to be Tarek going up into the box halls right now, but Groovy getting the entry onto the site. It's JDM. Will they expect another person up top? No one's checking it, and yeah, Rowland goes down. He goes, guys, where's my cover? Everyone was trying to push forward, and Tarek might have just been in the perfect position to win this round. Fugly making his rotation through CT, and round starts off great for Vex, but CLG very well done, and a good round there from Tarek being in the right place at the right time.
It looked ugly when Groovy got that first kill, but when I saw Tarek upper, I'm like, this is akin to... a take where if you picture, for example, a situation on Mirage, like on A site, where you have someone in that everybody executes through A ramp and then a CT pushes Palace. Then suddenly, even though everyone's coming up A ramp, if that guy Palace gets a kill or no one's there to stop him, then suddenly you feel so confident that him by himself could have so much impact and not die. And that's kind of the position that Tarek was in. So, I mean, they should have just 4-1'd it. Unless they were specifically trying to call out a setup that they saw from CLG where they didn't have someone upper.
Yeah, very surprised that no one was checking that after the first kill. Here's Repo, able to do what Furlan couldn't. Finds that Juan Deegan to Hayes, although he was operating with a little bit more information. Cutler back at the train stop. Here's those Deagles. He's like, you know what, actually, I'm just going to hide because those can kill you and turn the round around real quick.
Yeah, a couple of nades to TCOM would do a lot here, but... no one quite in position. Baiting them out into the site. Repo follows up with a second 1D. Huge plays from him.
Tarek back-to-back 3Ks. At least could maybe get a fourth here. Repo's been spotted on that green train.
Ooh, actually finds a third. No, it's on for the 1v3 at this point. 7 HP, however, gets shot in the back by Tarek. Cleans up that kill. Not afraid of the deke of Repo. Says, my gun's bigger.
And I was thinking that Vex, yeah, they got the plant, but no, they didn't. It was Rallen. He was the only one looking upper, but he was also punching in the code on the bomb, so he went down, which meant no plant.
Yep.
Vex Gaming, off of that round they just had, if they just had those deagles, got that many kills, how expensive it would have been for CLG forcing up here. Could have gone out to an early rifle, but no, not the case. Money is broken, and it will just be Glocks. I see one deagle and a P250 for Vex Gaming.
And you wonder what their strategy is. Again, pistols, we know, are going to be a huge factor in the scoreline because of how close we saw Dust 2 become. By the end of it, and 2-3 right now. JDM has a really powerful position on top of the train. Like, we see people play this, and the reason that they play so up close is if you have someone supporting you watching upper, you don't think they're going to come upper. Well, if you're on this ramp, especially versus the eco where someone might only have like one flash, you can't get blinded. Like, that flash will end lower ramp, and you'll see the flash, but then also not have to turn away. So that's super nice. But they don't even have a flash. I mean, they've got Glocks. Oscarish has decided to splurge and buy a deagle, but... yeah, instead of nades. You could have got smoke flash for the cost of the deagle, just saying.
Exactly.
But it would have been 5 Glocks. I mean, but their idea is to get a plant here.
Yeah, now they're going to actually have to find the kills. Tarek smoked upper catwalk now. It has since dissipated, but he still has a very strong angle. Now going to throw an incendiary. It might be a little bit late, but it won't matter. He pulls that gun back out, starts spraying him down. JDM going to be the one to get to, but Tarek did put in a ton of damage onto everyone. And JDM closing it out there with his third kill on the lower ramp. CLG doing exactly what they need to, starting off with 3 rounds in a row here on the CT side.
Part of the magic of the Polish squads is getting rolling early. And from a deficit, they will be able to, in this round, show themselves whether or not they have the confidence to win on T side. And I think if CLG give them this confidence, that we might see a type of momentum-based comeback. But if not, I think that buy-save situation might get vexed in their own head. So I'd say this is very, very critical for their stake in this game, or their stock in this game.
So... CLG, 3 outer, and won't play 2 inner initially, maybe expecting a quick hit once more, because Vex Gaming has been pretty much completely focused onto that B site, at least on their pistol and full eco rounds.
JDM supporting inner here, only with an MP7, however, so I think it's more useful in terms of his nades than anything else. And the full execute's coming up.
Yep, Rowland able to get out of catwalk for free. No one smoking it this time. No, Tarek will go down. JDM able to get one with that MP7, but it quickly falls apart. Oscarish really needed to get that kill. And instead, it'll leave it in a 3-on-3 post plant. Furlan looking to make the big play. He's gone down ladders, coming the other way through that Z connector. That Rowland, as well as Groovy, though, need to make some noise and distract them. so that they can buy time and be a big distraction, because Ferland is coming in on a massive flank. He's killed Cutler. Now Hayes knows exactly what's up. He'll have to turn around to deal with that. He dropped the smoke, flash off one side, smoke on the other, trying to defuse in it. But no, Ferland hits the shot, and yeah, game-winning play coming around outside into inner.
Yeah, game-winning play, you say.
Sorry, round-winning play.
Too late, mate.
All right.
Prediction has been made. It's on Reddit. Put it on Twitter. But Vax do win that crucial round. That, you know, I feel like matters quite a bit. Now, the thing is, that CLG do still have enough money even for the op to buy, so it might not be as critical as this one, because, you know, getting that save and getting the confidence up, I think, is going to be huge for a comeback on T side. But that time, they didn't even need a coordinated outer take or fast one. They did it going inner, and it was a little bit close, but Ferland really, really 100% of that round with that big flank.
And that could be a pivotal round. The first rifle is won by Vex Gaming. CLG, though, still with enough money to pull out a buy here. Scout onto Cutler, though, limited on that utility. JDM still with his op. That could be a difference maker. Rollin has his too. And enough utility for Vex if they want to take it slow and set up an execute.
Let's see. Tarik has a very important position on this map if he's going to be solo. Not only to get kills, but to make the decision on whether or not he needs to fast flank. And you know, flanking ladder is one of the ways to stick a fork in the plans of someone who wants to go outside. Will Vex, breaking out these windows, telegraph anything to CLG, or would they just consider it part of their routine? One assumption might be dangerous.
Yeah, of course, breaking those windows means you want to throw nades onto outside, and then breaking the windows is also a sound cue to tell CLG that you got people up in those halls. A lot of possibilities. Also could just be breaking them to, again, like, make them think about it.
Maybe just love chaos.
Yeah. Screw windows. I use Mac. Ferland moving down, coming out of the lower ramp. Tarik will shoot him in the head, and that's going to be the first kill of the round. 5-on-4. Time getting very, very low. Things not going well for Vex. Now 4-on-2. It's just up to Rollin and Oscarish, but with an op, could slow things down as they try to fight back. They need to do so quickly. Cutler finds a scout headshot onto Oscarish, and 4-on-1, Rallin running away. 5 seconds. Doesn't want to die after time, and probably won't.
Out here not so hot. I mean, Vex all died very quickly, but that's because they were all out there looking to trade, and no one could find the kills. Counter-Logic Gaming secure in 12th round, after shutting down, I think, one of what they felt was their biggest fears or toughest types of rounds to deal with, and that was a coordinated outer take from Vex. It wasn't exactly fast or out of spawn, but it was still, I'm sure, equally explosive to one just delayed. And, oh, this one could be a backbreaking round for Vex. Did they lose this because they actually spent a lot of money here?
Yeah, that's kind of the trap sometimes of saving that op. Rallin's money, he does not get any in that round.
Right. That's true.
He wasn't going to be able to buy with his team, so the rest of the team buys to his money, it looks like, and he's still at the op, and they're still going to be a little bit dangerous. Ferland's got that AK-47, and, you know, that's the 2-star players on this team right now. Rollin and Ferland with the big guns, they've got to make the difference. As long as Oscarish, Groovy, and Repo can just try to push out and make that space.
Tarik lurking around the smoke at inner. Won't actually be challenged either, so I don't know if he's going to fall off after this or if he's going to decide to push out, but he's going to see the smokes coming over, maybe think that now's the time to try to flank outer, and only one person at ladder is going down. No one's here to watch us back.
Oh, JDM very blind on the back of the green train. Rollin ops him out of the sky as he was trying to jump off and retreat. Cutler up on top of this bomb train. Oh man, Ferland, how does he expect that? Smoke everywhere, I guess. Cutler sticking out like a sore thumb.
And there's Tarik to make the play. He's coming out ladder. He actually goes down, though. And now it's 3v1. Hayes from the heaven position can be advantageous, but not in a 1v3. Vexed went around. And they're going tit for a tat. They actually did that with 3 Tech 9s. And the 3K from Rallin. Huge plays from Rallin. Actually up to 22 and 9. Continuing his aggression and dominance from the CT side.
Yeah, so CLG able to get off to that good start they needed. They get the pistol, the subsequent 2 rounds, but now in the last 3, the rounds that have had money, rifles, and armor in them all, it's actually Vex Gaming that have won 2 out of 3. And now it's CLG that has to make that kind of risky play. They go for that force up. If they win, either team in this round,
critical,
if they win, get a free round. The other team will be broken.
Yeah, I don't know if they justified the... I don't feel like CLG 100% justify the buy here, considering they didn't do that much damage last round of Vex. I mean, usually if you want to go, you want to trade rounds off a low buy, it's because it's contingent on the fact that you've done enough damage to make it so that the other team will save afterwards. But
they probably will. I mean, Repo, unless he gets some kills, will only have $1,400 if they lose this.
Yeah, but do they know that?
I mean, I think so, right? Rallen saved, so they know there's one round where he didn't get any loss bonus, and then everyone force bought behind it and bought to like pretty much $0. I think they could have made the read that they're broken, especially with a sixth man in the form of a coach, right?
That's true. Very powerful to have an extra set of eyes. And now JDM pushed up the ladder. Is this a ladder? Yeah, he is, but the take is going to be inner, and this might be Tarik getting overwhelmed here. He is going to have to make a huge play if they want to defend on this site.
Well, there's the first one onto Repo. There was a great flash that came out from someone that really delayed this, and now Tarik is reaping the rewards, able to get two. Cutler from the back, another scout headshot for him on this map on the CT side of it. 3-on-2, it's up to Rollin and Groovy to get something done for Vex Gaming. Flash goes out. Hayes, who is very blind, he's going to go up on the train. Oh, that would have been an incredible shot from Rollin. There's an incredible one. Speaking of those, Groovy takes it to just Fugly now. Moving out with the P250. Groovy gets the double, and you can hear the cheers. Each of those guys getting two kills in a very, very intense round. Tarik did his part, but you can see Hazed.
Wow, fantastically exciting. And wow, CLG, I mean, they had a round there that they should have won 100%. Tarik made a huge play getting those two frags. Both of them very difficult, and I think could have gone the other way. And from that advantage, that 3-on-2 in the after plant, Rallen stacks on another two kills.
Tarik Zeus. Zeus.
Tarik has a Zeus, yeah.
I wonder what he's doing. He was kind of just on top of the bomb train. Now he'll go up to E-Box. Maybe it was a mistake. I think maybe he's expecting a smoke wall to come out, then he can just camp in a smoke with a Zeus. Or I'm reading too much into it. No, he gets into a very, very close angle. Zeus goes out. No money for it, but man, does it look awesome. Ferlin, Rallen, and Oscarish then just saying, all right, we're not toying around. Don't tase me, bro. It's Cutler 1v4.
Didn't even have time to say it. Just a surprise. Popped out of the back of Sandwich. And now Cutler's all alone. And CLG, man, I mean, that last round has got to be haunting him a little bit. I mean, that's a huge round for Vex to come back into this game. And as we see, like, you know, CLG won the early rounds, won a very nice decisive rifle round after losing a round, and then lost two more. So haven't really gotten their feet on the ground economically. That's one thing to point out. But, you know, we can talk about that at the same time. All Vex are thinking is, look how many rounds we're winning on T-side. And Repo says, nice Zeus. It was very nice. Oh, Cutler picks up an AK.
That's huge.
Yep.
Because the money was not going to be great. That's going to allow at least one player, as they're all about, high 4Ks? Mid to high 4Ks in terms of their money, that's going to help a lot. $2,700 for free. And, you know, the best rifle in the game.
And that's why it's always good measure just to exit together whenever possible. So that trade can be killed, or that kill can be traded. And maybe so that kill doesn't happen at all.
So Vex within one of tying at CLG, of course, buying up, getting a bit of a bonus, but it won't be enough if they take a loss. This round, very, very important. Ferlin starts off with an entry. JDM, though, trading 4-on-4 now. Vex, how much control of Outer have they taken? They're trying to work out coordinating flashes. I can hear them all shouting. Oscar is going to get the kill onto Fugly. JDM just in between the bomb train still. The bomb, actually, it was a fake plant real quick. Another smoke looks like it's going to go down. It's Groovy with that bomb. Hasn't decided to plant it yet. JDM thinking and realizing he's susceptible to someone pushing off the back of the green train. This is a very, very precarious position for JDM. Tarik's able to get one, but then he goes down. JDM, 1v3, moves up. It's a fake plant, catches. Well, did catch Groovy off guard, but he'll stand tall, win that battle. It's 12-12, Vexed. The plow, I kind of hear the engine starting to rumble 4 rounds in a row.
Have finally tied, and yeah, they are back in this. They are back in this in a huge way, and after an 8-7.5, you wouldn't think that CLG winning the pistol, and after winning the pistol, would allow Vex to have staged a comeback such as this, but now they're on a buy-save situation, and even though, you know, JDM saved that AK, isn't going to be spending any money on this round, Vex, with their fast outer take, seem to be the ticket to success for them, and I wouldn't expect them to change up their strategy now.
All right, storming out. This is what we talked about. Those fast coordinated outer takes, seeing them a couple rounds now. This one, of course, just going against the pistols. Some deagles here for CLG, so it's not quite as difficult for them. And, well, Fugly will find one. Brings down Ferlin with a nice one deag. Tarik, ooh, gonna go and try to tap the bomb. Killing one more man. No, he won't. That deagle, not accurate after the first shot.
That's a rip.
Vex have the lead very late into map three.
And now this is one of the last chances here. CLG on max loss bonus. That's something to say. At a round deficit, have lost the last couple of rounds versus fast Outer Takes decisively. Have a lot to prove to themselves, and now is not the time to get nervous. JDM has to step up in a big way. He's got 15 kills right now, but he has that up, and we've seen Rowland have so much impact on the CT side. That's for good reason. It's because the op is so useful here.
Yeah, and he's having a very, very big game. Rollins 26-10. Oscar's 20-17, just looking at the top fraggers. And Tarek a little bit out there for CLG. He's on 21-16. The next closest are Haze and JDM at 15 apiece.
Definitely.
It was a pretty close frag distribution, but it looks like when it's got to the CT side, Tarek has done well.
Yeah, he was a monster inner on that last round that they hit it. And could probably shy them away from trying it again, but I think maybe they need to make some informational play. Like, CLG are playing outside and inside very scared. No IV control at all. No pushes to try to get information or opening frag. And I think that once they know that Vex are set up into a default, that they need to try to exploit something. And if they've watched demos, they should know. Like, for us, for example, we can see that IV's completely vacant, but they might not know that.
Well, Repo is watching it all the way back. And you can see Vex Gaming just all in a line pretty much on the left side of the radar. Watching everything very, very passive, expecting CLG to perhaps get nervous when the time starts going low. Maybe we'll show the tendency to over-rotate just because the pressure is really on right now. Hazed with the strong position out on the electrical E-box, Vex Gaming happened to go outside. And oh, it's Ferlin starting things off inner, 26 seconds, and there they go. Hazed falls as well, everything falling apart. But no, JDM brings it back. That's a 2-for-1 op shot. From back of Ivy, then he brings down Rollin. Now just Oscarish. Everything falls apart as JDM coming alive here. Big 3K on the round. Only took two bullets, and Oscarish going forward into 1v2. 10 seconds has the bomb. And oh, JDM, 4K.
That's a clipper. Huge impact from JDM. Gets the collateral in the midst of it and finishes off the last man in an exciting, really, really nicely played 4K from back lanes. So, will he continue to have that impact? Just went from 15 to 19, started to meet Tarek up at the top of the scoreboard. And that's what they need. They need one man outside to do work and one man inside to do work and everyone else to kind of contribute to trade frags and stuff like that. But I wonder if the standard setup will work again. We have Vex now looking to take the lead once again and for them to set the pace as well. They killed Tarek last round, and it looked like they're going to try to do it again.
Oh, JDM's here supporting with the op, and Tarek able to get the best of Oscarish. So CLG starting out 5-on-3 in this round. Great defense, great inner hold, not going to be caught off guard. And whoa, AK delivered through the end of that smoke. Oh, beautiful boost though. Pulling out all the stops to try to get back into this round. Rollin boosts up, looks over that new area they added when they revamped train. And finds himself a frag. Now looking to do the same thing off the upper catwalk. Hasn't found anything yet. Looks like Cutler might want to peek out, but won't do so yet.
Oh, I think the scope is definitely heard by Tarek, who actually has another smoke, which is huge for him, because he can continue to play this position with it. And upper is being focused on one man outside only, Fugly. So 3v3, inner if it is the case that Vex want to go through, and it looks like Grubby's going to throw the flash. And
not committing just yet, and inner, of course, is normally easy to take because it's just one person, but CLG are pretty aware of what's going on. They've got two in here. Great shot by Cutler. Never peeking that op of Rollin, and there he wins out, having held the angle. It's up to Groovy and Repo, 2 versus 4, 29 seconds. Repo's also going to try his hand at the op, and I think that weapon switch might have been heard as the AK clunks on the ground.
What is their play here? 20 seconds. They don't have much time to make presence at the other site. They actually have a couple of nades to do it, but no smoke or anything like that to cross with cover or make it seem that way. And it seems like they're actually just going to save.
If they save, they can actually drop some guns and get a buy. Yeah. Limited utility in the next round, but that looks like what they're going to have to do. And if Repo dies after time.
What a shot. Oh, my goodness. And that just saves an op, which is huge. And that is money that CLG wanted to hang on to as well. I mean, they're not exactly sitting pretty at the moment. So that's a huge no scope.
Okay, so Repo and Ferlin are extremely poor. If Repo had died after time, that would have been monumental. That probably would have been map 3 for CLG, but Vex Gaming still with another shot here. Op glass cannon granted onto Rowland, as I think he bought an AK for Repo, and then everyone else with nades. CLG with a pretty healthy buy themselves.
It looks like they're asserting themselves at Ivy for the first time in a few rounds. We haven't seen it many times. What will this mean? I mean, they're still going up against the op of JDM, who is actually just holding that TCON spot that he loves to watch from Trainstopper.
Yeah, so they're putting faith in Tarek here, that the star player for this team, in a lot of people's eyes, to hold the inner sight by himself. And he has been very good at that thus far on the CT side, and it's a big stack into the outer yard for CLG. Three people, and even Haze, very aggressive on E-Box. Fugly, a little bit more passive, but in the back CT hall, watching anyone that's going to push through Ivy, and also supporting JDM in case he gets into trouble with his op.
I think Rowland must have heard that scope at the end of Ivy there, but it looks like he's fallen out. Didn't have the advantageous angle for that shot. And now he's going to move his talents to TCON.
And we can see Ferland looking at the ground. Not because there's anything down there, but he is lining up a smoke. Maybe picking up a lucky penny. Who knows? That says to me they want to do an outer take.
Definitely feels like it. 2-3 with TCON and Ladder after having making some presence at Ivy. Keep him honest. JDM is going to have his attention split.
Yeah, no one's actually at Ivy. Hazed. At the boxes of Ladder, beautiful first shot onto Groovy. JDM will take down Ferland. Haze blind, almost able to get one more, but there's Oscarish finally starting things off for Vex Gaming. They find themselves 3v4. Smoke's going down, bomb going down. More money coming in for them, but it looks like CLG poised to take the round. 4v2. JDM, another great shot onto Rowland, and Repo will fall to Fugly. You can hear the cheers. Let's go, they save. About to be 15-13. CLG have gone on to match point.
I think that was just Haze alone yelling. Super loud.
His emotions have been on a roller coaster in this best of three. Yeah. We've seen him super hyped. We saw him head on the table. And now he's hyped again.
Poor Haze. Such a nice guy, too. But wow. Yeah, and JDM having that impact outside. And that's been the key point, I think, for CLG. Coming alive at the end when it matters. Have match point one round away from being able to qualify for the major. Whereas Vex have to win two on the T side of train. Not a small task. The smokes are coming out outer. But no one's actually moved up quite yet.
Oh, one smoke, maybe try to bait some rotations.
That's their only smoke.
Yeah, that's true. Four flashes is now all they have to work with. Rowland is glass AK. That's not a good thing to have. As money was very tight, but they're going to try to do everything they can to stay in it. Galil also won Ferland, and it's CLG. It's certainly their round to lose right now. Tarek still playing inside by himself, giving some quick jiggle peeks. Not sure if he saw something or it's just a certain time of the round he likes to back off. Back at Pop Dog now. We'll peek out. He's starting to spot people. Two quick headshots with the spray. JDM out of the Z connector, getting one more. That will allow one to cross and another one to drop off of the catwalk. So onto the back of the bomb train. 2v4. Oscarish brings down Hazed. Now 3 retaking onto 2. Bomb planted. Molotov going to push Oscarish back. And Rollin holding out on the back of the site. There's one of those flashes. That's the last one. No more utility for the Terrace. Fugly extremely blind, but he's safe. Cutler gets a headshot onto Rowland, and now Oscarish. They are actually splitting up, but it's 3v1. And Fugly will get it. It's CLG. They're going to be the third North American team heading to the major. Well played by Vex, but in the end, it's CLG that find that CT side. And there you go. No failed high fives after map 3.
Wow. Yeah, fantastic performance. I mean, they actually just came back after a close dust 2 loss, and they found their footing on the CT side of train after giving up 5 rounds in a row to the explosiveness of Vex, and now qualify for their spot in the major, and they got to be feeling relieved, excited. It's been a good couple of days for North America.
Yes, it has.
Yeah, not losing a single best of one or best of three. All haven't qualified.
So big performers on that one. The first half wasn't no one pulling ahead, everyone actually pulling their weight on the first half of train. The kills were pretty equal going into the CT side, and that's the side that we were very concerned about. Ryu made me very concerned about it, at least when I talked to him. And that's when Tarek and JDM really, really stepped up. We finally see a pretty sick performance from JDM, 23-17 plus 6. Tarek's 25-18, that's plus 7. So great killing potential there, and very good communication on the retakes.
Yeah, America.
America, thank you, Launders. Pro analyst right here. Just kidding. We're going to go to the real pros. They're down on the desk. Guys, take it away.
More, when you say you love America, at least say it like you mean it. Because, you know, I do. I love this place. It's great. Can't wait to be here. Anyway, CLG, they've got there in the end.
Yeah.
It wasn't a vintage performance. I think them perhaps celebrating a bit wildly, considering it was squeaky bum time, as they say in the UK.
Wrong casters.
How are you feeling about it?
Still wasn't super impressed, but listen, like, the big thing is JDM had a bad series, showed up on the last map when it was needed, especially in the Crucial Round, because he actually didn't seem like he was having that great of a match up until the last five rounds or so when they actually needed him to come up. Tarek had a good game as well, so, I mean, we mentioned both those players rarely sync up together at the same time, and this match they did, and then they took it away.
What do you think?
Yeah, no, Tarek obviously series MVP for Countlogic Gaming side of things, and I mean, that's why I said I switched my vote at the last minute and went with Vexed for Train, is because despite the map being balanced, probably leaning over towards CLG's side, JDM hadn't been there, and you could see it was going to take a JDM performance for him to win the game. He did turn up on this third map, though. I think overall for the LAN, it hasn't been a good performance. Like, he's in the major, but this has not been like a classic JDM performance. It hasn't been the stability we expect of the player I considered NA's best player at the moment, actually. So he's slipped off a bit, but he did get it together on this last map. And despite, I mean, you've got to give credit to Vexed. This wasn't a good map for them, but they really came close to potentially winning this and getting to the major.
We've got a replay here which shows one of the turning points. This replay brought to you by The Score Esports. And you can see here that this is when Vexed are in the lead. It's 13-12. Vexed getting off to a great start, but CLG do just a monster hold there. JDM picking up a double, I think it was. Yeah. And then he gets another one there through the smoke, jumping around the back of the trains, and leaves the stand-in, Oscarish, with a 1v2 situation. He's looking around, trying to get that intel, and then JDM gets that fourth kill.
The way he was jumping around left him in a veritable house of pain.
I like that. It's good 90s hip-hop reference game. Incredibly on point. So, yeah, it was, I mean, you know, like you say, JDM did pull out a performance in the end.
Yep.
A few words about Vexed, I guess. I felt that. But Duncan's right, you know, you could see they weren't quite at home on the map, their executes weren't quite as slick as they could be, but they were getting the bomb down repeatedly. Their economy, you know, was kind of always there for them. They could get these buys, and they you know, there was a few key rounds where they could have turned this round and maybe won it.
Yeah, I think part of it was just too slow to get start in the first half. I think they had a tough time managing the economy. Once they started getting aggressive on choke points, that's kind of when they started evening out the score in their defense. CLG got out to a big lead early on, and that's kind of what propelled them forward going into the second half.
Yeah, and what did you make of Vex's performance overall? Signs of encouragement here? I mean, keep in mind, they were using a stand-in.
Yeah. I mean, when you consider the only map they got dominated on was actually their map pick. On the others, the ones that I expected to be pretty decently slanted over to the CLG side of things, Vex played pretty well. They really pushed CLG. Obviously, they were very good on Cobble in comparison to CLG's performance. Mm. I mean, I think overall, when you look at the tournament, obviously, if you're Vexed, it's going to be disappointing because you, like I said, you really were a best of one against Splice, unknown team to get to the major. You didn't get there. Then you've come almost as close as you can get in this series. You haven't gotten there. Pick ban even kind of went your way. I feel like they had every chance to make it to this major, so they didn't. They've only themselves to blame in that respect. No one screwed them over in any sense here. And CLG, I mean, it's hard to feel good about that victory, even though it is a victory.
Yeah, I agree. Shame for Vexed. It could have been very different had Hyper been here.
Exactly. We'll also wonder about that, right?
Yeah, we'll never know. But anyway, thanks for your thoughts, gentlemen. We're going to go over to the stage. We've got Chris Puckett there with the victorious JDM from CLG.
Thank you, fellas. Here with the Game Changer, JDM. You clutched up for your squad, my friend. The Game Changer moment, we all saw it. Four kills in the late half there of the CT side. Break it down for me, my friend. It looked like it started to spin out of control, but you pulled your team right back in it.
I mean, to be honest with you, I don't even want to talk about the 4K. I just want to talk about my teammates playing like so well, man. They carried me throughout this whole weekend. I am actually pretty disappointed in my gameplay. But they did awesome, man. They did awesome.
Well, we kind of saw a rough start for you guys. You went up against Splice. What went wrong for you guys on Friday night? Did you just underestimate them?
Could be like that. Splice came in with like a lot of hunger. They had nothing to lose. And shout out to the Mongols. I feel bad for them. They deserve to be here. But Splice did their thing. But, I mean, I don't know. I think it was just miscoms. Maybe just like they said, they had nothing to lose. We, I think, probably came in a little bit too cocky, maybe, like because we were favored for the group. But yeah, I mean, it was a rough start. That's how CLG works, though. We always start off rough and then end up, you know, making it out. So
you definitely make it entertaining for the fans, to say the least. We saw a very close match against SK, and then today, we thought you were going to be able to wrap it up in two. You beat your opponents on their map choice. Then it went to Cobble. Talk me through kind of the map selection. Why didn't you guys go with Mirage? That was kind of the most popular question I saw on Twitter.
I mean, we still are working on a lot of things with setups and everything. We're changing a lot during practices. And I believe that right now, I mean, it might not look like it, but it just to us right now, it seems like Kabul is probably our better map. We got destroyed. Vex played amazing. But yeah, we just went with Kabul because of the fact that right now, as of right now, with this five and with PETA calling, that Kabul's our best map.
After the map draw, you found out if it goes to game three, you'll be playing on Train. What went through your mind when you saw that? And what went through your mind after game two when you knew it was all going to come down to this?
Well, we are really actually like not prepared on Train at all. We just switched up a setup and we haven't even tried it for CT side. And like Train was probably one of the last maps that we've actually kind of worked on. So we had to play one ESA match on Train. But, you know, we weren't really prepared on Train. But we used to be good on Train back when Finesse was on the team. So we just, you know, game two, no matter what, even though we lost Kabul, we got to think to ourselves that, you know, this is still ours. And, you know, we just got to hit our shots and play together, have good comms, and we can do this. So.
Well, the shots started to land, man. CLG. Back in the major, we have one more match, and before I let you go, I gotta get the prediction. Cloud9 playing Renegades, best of three, last match of the entire tournament. Who's joining you here at the Million Dollar Major?
You know what? Both great teams. But I'm gonna go with Cloud9, man. America. We need America right now.
All right.
Got it.
It's calling Cloud9, guys. Let us know if you agree in the chat. Let us know on Twitter. JDM will be watching on with the rest of us. Don't go anywhere. More Counter-Strike Global Offensive when we return.